Yo, what is up, Brick Squad, and welcome back to another video here on the channel. And today, guys, I'm super stoked to bring you week one, the very first official installment here on the channel of building Anaxes in Lego. This project should actually take us through the rest of 2019, probably maybe a little earlier than that, but this project is going to be great. It's definitely going to be a huge fun ride for all of you guys to join us. And before we go ahead and get any further, odds are that about 60% of you guys watching this video are not subscribed to the channel, and all I do ask is that by the end of this video, I hope that you can subscribe to the channel. It really helps me out, and of course I don't think you're going to want to miss any of this fantastic, awesome, fun journey that we will be embarking on today. And of course, guys, let's go ahead and smash the like button down below. I want to risk it. I think we can get 100 likes today. Let me know what you guys think about that. So now, before we go ahead and get on into any of the building Anaxes sort of logistics information, I do have a lot of stuff to show you guys. If you can see by the laptop, maybe on frame a little bit, I have some LDD and stud IR renders of some items. We do have the clone army, obviously, and a huge awesome layout that we will get into later on in the video, but I do want to quickly introduce three of our sponsors for this channel. One of them is going to be an awesome returning sponsor. If you guys join me for my Building Kessel in Lego series, Brick Stuff is going to be a returning sponsor again, so huge thank you to Rob. Rob is 100% without a doubt one of the big reasons why Kessel was received so amazingly as it was, especially with the custom light up products. For those of you who are not familiar with Brick Stuff, basically they are a custom light up company that does a whole bunch of kits and just custom light products, so definitely go check them out. Links will be down below in the description. Now we should go ahead and introduce our two other sponsors. Number two is going to be Minifigs for You. You guys know Solid Brick Studios David. David graciously sent me his Bad Batch figures, which we will get into later today, and we'll undoubtedly be supplying more minifigures and just products as the time goes. So if you guys are looking to buy Bad Batch and maybe build your own little Anaxes mock yourself, definitely go ahead and check out minifigs4u.com, link down below. And last but not least, a man who has seriously helped out this project through monetary donations. His name is Paul, or PRM Brick Studios. He is, without a doubt, one of the largest contributors to the channel, just in general, not even just the mock series, but he has decided to become an official sponsor for Anaxes, so definitely go ahead and check out PRM Brick Studios down below in the description. All right, so with all that stuff out of the way, let's go ahead and talk about Anaxes. So for those of you who are not familiar with the weekly build series, if you guys have not seen David's Kashyyyk or David Scarif or Crate or Jay and Garrett's Crate, or even my sort of past Kessel videos, and other weekly series videos, you know that week one is basically the week devoted to talking a lot about the mock, hence why I spent a considerable amount of time drawing up a plan about Anaxes and what I think that we will be doing. Now, that being said, there is no build progress in today's video per se. Week one of most of the build series out here on YouTube is going to be consisting of talking a lot about the plans, the visions, and the goals as to what you want to, or I guess me in particular, what I want to achieve down the road with the mock. But for those of you who have no idea what Anaxes is, basically it is a planet in the Clone Wars released, or I guess unofficially released episodes, and then obviously we are getting them back in the upcoming Clone Wars Season 7 trailer. There are a few options when it comes to building Anaxes as to what you can do. You do the factory, you can do the giant battle that we will be getting in Season 7. However, what I have decided to do is actually build the fort itself that includes the giant backdrop mountain and sort of the crate-like door, which is kind of funny. But basically, the vision I have for this mock is going to be creating a huge fort that means walls, watchtowers, lots of buildings, lots of ATTEs, gunships, headhunters, all that stuff. Basically, it's just going to be a fort to sort of house a standing army. Now, being said, basically what I am building is going to be a gigantic military-styled fort that is going to be housing hundreds and hundreds of clones and dozens of vehicles. So there is not going to be a giant battle per se. However, I do want to hint at something later on, maybe down the road in a couple of months, that I might have a couple other buddies who I know who are maybe building some other Anaxes mocks, and maybe I'll be coming back. But that stuff is for down the road. We are nowhere near even thinking about the next project after this because we haven't even started. So that kind of brings a conclusion to the overall introduction. Let's go ahead and jump on into the overall designs that I have, what I have sort of concocted, and all the different ideas that I have for the Anaxes series. So let's go ahead and get started. So now, before we go ahead and get started with talking about just the overall mock layout, let's briefly talk about all these minifigures. As you guys know, in the beginning of the video, one of the three sponsors is Minifigs for You, and David was kind enough to graciously supply the entire Anaxes squad right here in front of you guys. And of course, Anaxes and Bad Batch is sort of like the dynamic duo. I feel if you have the Bad Batch, or if you have Anaxes, you kind of have to have the other. So again, if you want to go ahead and check out these figures, they are available at minifigs4u.com, link in the description. But overall, Anaxes consists of a Phase 2 clone sort of army battalion. Right here is 100 of the normal Phase 2 clones. What I've been doing is getting the Phase 1 clones from the new battle pack here, or not the new one, but the most recent one. Here it is, the Jedi Clone Battle Pack. You guys can see the torso for the Phase 2 is actually very, very eerily similar to that. Well, that's just basically because it is. All I've been doing is basically filtering out the helmets, the old Phase 1 helmets components that LEGO includes and basically swapping them out for the brand new Aerialite Phase 2. A link to that product will be in the description. Huge shout out to Blues. As of now, we have 100 of the normal Phase 2 clones right here, and the idea is actually to have this double in size. As I'll go into later in the video, I basically want to have a large walkway where it's consisting of like 150 clones by itself. So I think it's going to be a pretty ambitious project, but this is where we're standing on that. And of course, it wouldn't be a Clone Wars mock without the 501st. We have 7 of the official LEGO 501st troopers, and then we do have the CAC Rex and CAC Oppo, I believe his name is, and then just a CAC normal Phase 2 501st clone right there. So this is where the army stands right now. This is definitely a good spot to start. I don't think we'll be spending too much time on this army. However, if you guys want to stay tuned, I actually do a mini army clone building series every like 2 or 3 weeks on the channel. Basically, whenever I add a significant amount of figures to the standing army, I'll make an update video, and those videos did really well, so make sure you guys go ahead and stay tuned for that if you want to stay up to date more with this clone army growing. This right here is definitely a really good position to be in. I don't think we need to really divulge or spend any more materials and money on clones at the moment. However, when the build series sort of comes to an end, when we're coming towards the finale in the later half, I think we will need to obviously order more, but this is definitely a good enough army and a good place to start. All right, so guys, here on your screen is an image of the Stud.io rendered sort of layout of the entire base. You guys can see it is consisting of all 6x4 gray base plates. You can see the wall outline that I actually have built for the actual Anaxes mock. Now, the idea is to have the front section closest to you, the part of the image that's closest to you right now, that is going to be the area for the very minimal foliage and just a whole bunch of like ground dirt stuff going on with the terrain. And then if you go to the other side of the wall and you go towards that back sort of sixth of the mock, that is going to be where the base wall is going to be. That's where the mountain's going to be, and the area in between where the mountain is will be on that back layer. And of course, the wall is going to be consisting of roads and a whole bunch of other activities going on. Here is a close-up image of the actual technique that I have chosen to go with for the wall. I was looking for something that was very easy to replicate, but also gave it a very classic Clone Wars look, but also giving it a little bit of like an Old Republic sort of Jedi Temple feel. And I think I really did knock that out of the park. I really like how it came together. So of course, let me know what you guys think about that down below. Basically, it consists of lots of light bluish gray and dark bluish gray pieces. There are lots of slopes and lots of just really cool not any intricate techniques though. It's actually really simple to build, so if you guys want to go ahead and try this for yourselves, be my guest. I'd love to see this recreated on another scale that I'm already doing it. But again, here is just an image of the entire mock layout. Obviously, within this sort of little rectangle square area, I do plan on fitting everything that I mentioned before in the video, all those buildings, all the snot walkways, all the amazing detail coming in. So that is sort of the goal with this mock render. Let's go ahead and jump back to the video right now. Alrighty guys, so probably the most important part of this week's update is going to be talking a lot about the general plans here that I have sort of designed for Anaxes. Now, if you guys are familiar with the build series, obviously there is a part of the LEGO series in general where you basically just make a diorama and a drop of what you want to do in your plans, and that's basically what I've done here. So it's obviously going to be a large majority of today's video explaining everything that I really want to do in terms of what I want to do for Anaxes and building. So here overall, we do have a 6x4 grid base plate sort of map. Obviously, each of these squares represents a normal size grid base plate. First off, let's go ahead and talk about this section here. If you guys can follow, this is like a weird base plate that I cut. But basically, if you can follow this area right here, this is going to be the entire outline of the wall. If you guys saw that rendered image a couple of minutes ago, that is what I was talking about right now. So on your screen right now will be actually a rendered image of this wall. And basically, this entire like half open rectangle kind of thing right here, that's going to be the entire wall spanning across a little over 4 base plates. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 4.5 kind of in the front. It's obviously replicated on the other side of the mock as well. Now, what's really cool is that we will also be including towers. I don't know if you guys can see, but I've included 4 different circles here. We have 1, 2, 3, and 4 on either side of the base wall. These are sort of like watchtowers, obviously keeping guard for the clones and making sure they are secure. But I've marked them as T1, T2, T3, and T4, obviously for tower 1 and etc. This whole section right here is going to be the whole open area, and here I have written a red foliage and dark bluish gray terrain. The Anaxes that I'm building during the Clone Wars series consists of a dark bluish gray terrain with lots of red vegetation. There's really some really cool unique trees and flowers and just other cool stuff like that that I will obviously be exploring for the build series itself. Now, that's going to be consisting around this whole entire front section leading up to the base wall right here, and this is the entrance. Now, this whole dotted line thing that you guys can see right here, this dotted line there and a dotted line there, all the area in between there is actually going to be a giant snot, which means stud, not on top. It's going to be a giant snot pathway, basically like a walkway going through the middle of the base. I'll put an image on your screen right now. Basically, that whole middle row of where the gunships and the ATTs and the troops are, that is essentially what I'll be building. So the idea is to have this basically be the main event of the mock. We're going to have two custom ATTs. In fact, I'll put an image on the screen right now of the ATTE that I'm using. A huge thank you to a mock shop on Instagram. He actually was gracious enough to send me the file, so make sure you guys go and check him out. Of course, when I go in building that, of course, when I go ahead and build the actual ATTE, that'll be its own sort of weekly segment. I'm actually planning on including two, which is going to be great, and then in between each of them, we're going to have three sections of troops. I'll try and zoom in a little closer here. You guys can see we have troop, basically section one, section two, and section three. The idea is to have that be sort of the main sort of event. Like, obviously, we're going to have a lot of clones for it as if it's mobilizing to get ready for an attack or to attack the separatist outpost. So basically, we're going to have a whole line of troops, ATTEs, a whole bunch of vehicles, which is going to be awesome. Now, you guys can also see a section titled landing pad. Right here is going to be consisting of two gunships, which I will put up on your screen right now. This is a brickable design. It's not my own design, but I do think it looks really awesome, so I'm definitely going to go with that. And I think there's going to be enough room for one headhunter. I'm not sure if that's going to be using the Lego set or not, but basically that's going to be consisting of the area right here marked landing pad. Up here on the top section of the base here, we're going to have a couple of things. Number one, we're going to have two identical barracks. Obviously, if you're at a base and you're a military personnel, you're going to need a place to stay. I have already started designing the barracks. However, I will wait until next week to show you guys what I have done just so I can finalize it. But there are going to be two barrack buildings right here. Those are going to be the first things that you see. Here is going to be a wall, sort of like a partition in between a desk, but instead it's a partition between the barrack and the shield generator. Now, the shield generator is something that you guys probably did see in the Season 7 trailer, the very first one that was released, and it's a pretty crucial part of the mock. I think it looks very iconic. Obviously, it's inspired from Hoth and the shield generator there. So the only issue that I have with recreating that is going to be I'm going to have to make it pretty large. It's going to be covering at least half a base plate, so we're going to see where that goes. And then in between and throughout the top section here, we're going to be littering the area with supply crates and supply bins and mini patrols and a whole bunch of activities. So that is the idea for the top section of the base. If you kind of think about it, each base has like a third, right? We have the top third barrack here, we have the second third, and we have the third on the bottom, which again we'll go ahead and talk about right now. Now here is the bottom third of the base, and here you can see the very first building we have on the side is going to be called the medical bay. I thought that basically if you have a base, you're going to need a med bay. It only makes sense. I think I really have a lot of fun and enjoyment creating my own sort of med bay, so that'll be building number one on the bottom third. Now what's going to be really fun to make is going to be the mess hall. This is obviously going to be the place where the clones can take a break from their missions and go ahead and grab some grub. That's basically going to be covering over a base plate in length, and that's going to be a really fun project to do. And then here on the side here, we basically have an arsenal or like a weapons depot, which again, I think it's, since it's a base, it's a fort, it would only make sense to have sort of an arsenal and like a weapons depot. A question I do want to pose to all you guys right now is actually, I do plan on including like a supporter lounge. If you guys are familiar with my boy Rich Boy Jay, he did his Boyo lounge, and obviously we got to get a brick squad lounge going on, but I'm not sure where to put it in the mock, so if you guys have any suggestions, of course, let me know. Then really the only other thing to talk about is going to be the base wall right here. Now this is basically the mountains right here marked with the spikes, and then this is going to be the actual constructed clone wall. It's really cool and unique about the Anaxes mountain. I'll put an image up on your screen right now. It's not really I guess it's not a natural occurring wall, a mountain wall. It's sort of like a clean slate, if that makes sense. It's sort of like someone took a laser and cut right through the top to bottom. So the mountain's going to actually be not that difficult to make, but it is going to take a crazy amount of brick and very minimal slopes, but that's going to be something that we will get to obviously when we come to it. And then recreating that base wall is going to be kind of almost like recreating another crate wall. It's going to be interesting to see how we do that, obviously, but that's going to be one of the very last things that we do. We will focus on finishing the base first and getting as much progress done there, and then when the time is right, we will go ahead and focus all of our attention to the other side here. And then I guess as one of the very last things to show you guys today, as I do want to show you the entire area as to where I'm building this mock. So here is the table. We have all 24 base plates. In fact, I'm actually missing one, which was a miscalculation on my part, so we will get that finished as soon as we can. But this is the area that I will be building. We have a window for natural light. We have plenty of height room for that mock, and especially for that mountain and that base wall. And then this is going to be the entire scale of it. And honestly, I think this is kind of cool just to show you. I'll put the minifigures around where that middle pathway will be, and you guys can see just how big this mock is going to be. Those minifigures, that's over 100 minifigures right there, and for some reason it looks absolutely puny compared to the rest of the mock. So this is the area that I'm working with. I'm really excited. It's a lot of open area. Obviously we have more storage with all the parts and around here. So we are really ready to rock and roll here for this mock, which is great. But let's go ahead and jump to the outro of today's video. Alrighty everyone, that is going to wrap up week one of building Anaxes in Lego. I'm not going to lie, I've gotten the adrenaline rush from coming back and doing these styled videos. I absolutely love these weekly segments, and I hope that you guys did enjoy. And of course, if you guys aren't subscribed, please consider subscribing, because that seriously does help a lot. And I really do think you guys are genuinely going to want to invest yourself in these episodes. Some of you may know, or if you didn't know, usually these parts of the videos will conclude about what I'm sort of envisioning for the next week. The next week, I'll start to work on the very front of the base. Basically, it's going to consist of me building the very beginnings of the terrain and maybe even getting the base wall. Now, as I said, the goal for this Anaxes mock, which is going to be the most difficult thing for me, is making it entirely modular, making all the buildings, all the wall segments, everything about this mock needs to be transported very easily. So that's going to be something I'm going to have to spend a lot of time experimenting with, seeing what works for my needs. Obviously, the goal is to have this at Chicago and Virginia next year in 2020. So again, the goal is to make this thing as compact and easily transportable as possible. I will be bringing back, obviously, the building series live streams. Building Anaxes in Lego will take place sometime during the weekday of this coming week. Please stay tuned on my Instagram and Twitter at TheBrickWiz. I will always let you guys know, of course, when I'm going to be streaming. You guys are not going to miss those. Those are the streams where I actually get the progress done, where I actually do the physical building. And of course, you guys can be there and be some of the first people in the world to see that stuff unfold. So please make sure you guys subscribe, hit that notification bell, make sure you guys are all staying tuned for those epic streams coming later. Before we go ahead and get out of the video today, I'm not sure how long the runtime is right now, I do want to give a huge thank you to all you incredibly generous people who have decided to donate some of your hard-earned money towards the project. That's also something crazy that happens on these streams. I have people donate to me upwards of hundreds and hundreds of dollars, and I may or may not cry a couple of times, but it really does make me happy that some of you guys are so invested and really just have that much faith in me to build these projects and really just make it to the best of my ability. So I do want to give a huge thank you to you guys sincerely from the bottom of my heart. And all you guys watching this video right now, I wish I could give you a giant hug. You guys seriously mean the world. Guys, let's go ahead and smash the like button on this video. I want this video to do really, really well. I want a lot of people, I want to gain a lot of traction with this series. I think a lot of people are going to come to enjoy it. Everyone, that is going to wrap up the week one of building Anaxes in Lego. Hope you all enjoyed. Obviously, stay tuned next Saturday for building Anaxes in Lego week number two. And of course, the streams going on throughout the week of me getting the progress physically done, which is going to be an incredibly fun time. Until then, guys, enjoy the rest of your weekend. Have a fantastic Saturday. And I cannot wait for tomorrow's Game of Thrones episode. Anyways, guys, it's been your boy Matt, and I'll see you later. Peace.